Hi, I'm Matt, and this is my dad, Emeritus Professor Charles Griffiths. He's an expert in marine biology and has found a ton of new species. And together, we're going to explore the shore. So Dad, what are we looking for today?
Okay, well, today we're going to have a look for some chitons. And chitons are a primitive group of molluscs. And they actually have eight shells. So unlike bivalves, like mussels that have two shells, or gastropods, or snails that have a single coiled shell, these guys have eight shells along their backs. And that's a vestige of evolution. It's a vestige of segmentation. So they evolved from some segmented animal like a worm. They're the most primitive group of molluscs. So let's see if we can find one. Here's the tulip chiton. This is one of the prettier chitons that we get, with this very pretty mottled coloration along the eight shell valves. And then quite big fish-like scales on the girdle. So on this individual you can see really, really clearly that the body is made up of eight shell plates going from the head here to the tail. Now these shell plates can flex against one another, so if I was to pick this animal off the rock, it would be able to curl up like a woodlouse.
For protection.
For protection, yeah. And then maybe roll around and find a new place to live and then unroll and glue itself back onto the rock.
So they look quite something from the dinosaur.
They're very primitive. They're certainly the most primitive group of mollusks. And from these eight shell plates, we would evolve to having two shell plates in the bivalves, like the mussels and clams, and only one in the snails, and then in the octopuses, which are the most advanced group, there's no shell left at all. So the shell gradually kind of becomes lost through evolution. And then around these eight shell plates, you have a rim that presses tightly against the rock, and that's called the girdle. And in this specimen, and in many chitons, that girdle's completely covered with little overlapping scales, like fish scales. So the animal's very heavily armored and protected. And it spends most of its time glued tightly to the rocks. Not many things eat them. They're very hard to attack.
And they're also herbivorous. Are they eating the algae?
Yes, so all of these animals are herbivorous and they're mostly nocturnal. So this animal was on the underside of this rock, and then at night he'll emerge and crawl around to the top side of the rock, which may have some algae on it, and then graze the algae. Another interesting fact about these actually is that they're blind in the sense that they don't have eyes, but they actually have light sensitive cells in the plates, in the shell plates. So they can tell the difference between light and dark, but they're reading it out of their backs. They're sensing the light on their backs. He's moving along ever so slowly then actually as we're speaking. He's heading towards my thumb, moving over. Running for safety.
Get out of the
light. At 1 centimeter an hour.
He's probably trying to get out the sun, right?
Yes, of course he doesn't like the sun. He's almost got around this corner now. He's racing for the finish line. It's the Chiton Olympics. And we'll be back next week to see the finish. Oh, yeah, okay, come and have a look at this. We've got a giant chiton over here. Okay, this species is by far the largest chiton that we find on the South African coastline. And not surprisingly, it's called the giant chiton. And it has a different feeding method to other chitons, which just go out and graze. The giant chiton raises the front end of its body and waits for a piece of drift seaweed to come floating along, and then it clamps down its head over the bit of drift seaweed and eats it. This one's surprisingly out in the open. But here we've got a not terribly giant chiton, but because it's attached to a small rock here, you can see the features really nicely. So one of the characteristic things about this chiton is along the girdle there, these little tufts of black hairs. Let's put him back into his spot. Here's another giant chiton. This is more typically the way that you would see them. They're almost always half buried in the sand. So most of them are nocturnal. This one is actually one of the very few that you actually see out in the open on the top of the rock. And that's because it's protected by these little tufts of spines, and those spines are irritant spines. So this is one of actually the few animals on the seashore in South Africa which one doesn't want to handle. And at this end there'll be a mouth. Inside that mouth will be a long rasping tongue called the radula, and it uses that rasping tongue to scrape seaweeds off the surface of the rocks.